Good morning, everyone. So for today's discussion, so ang topic natin ngayon is all about determining the measures of the exterior angle of a convex polygon. So this is for the grade 7 mathematics third quarter for the school year 2021-2022. So first, before we proceed to our lesson, so let me give to you our main objective for today. So the main objective, you or the learner, determines the measure of the exterior angles of a convex polygon using the polygon exterior angle theorem. So, since you don't have any idea, or maybe some of you don't have the idea about the polygon exterior angle theorem, so as we go along the discussions, so you will be able to learn how to define or how to determine the measures of the exterior angles of a convex polygon using the polygon exterior angle theorem. Okay, so before we start, so I'm posting here in your screen a situation, so a practical situation or a practical application of this lesson. So let me read to you. So an after school club was doing a crop as preparation for their culminating activity in MAPE. So students are very excited doing their display with paper cut out in shape of a convex regular polygon. So the question here is, if one of the exterior angles has measures of 45 degrees, what is the name of the polygon? Okay, so can you be able to find the measures, or can you be able to name the polygon if the measure of the exterior angle is 45? Okay, so don't worry, because as we go along the discussion, you will be able now to find what is the answer in this given problem. So, ipopose ko lang itong problem. Then, after natin ma-discuss yung particular lesson ngayon, so, mas maiintindihan nyo kung paano natin masosolve itong problem. So, iiwan muna natin itong problem na to. Okay. So, before we proceed, so, let's have a short recall about the lines. Okay, so, two lines intersect. So, let's say, we have line P and line M intersect at point O. Now, the question is, if two lines intersect, how many angles are being formed? Okay, you were right. So, there were four angles being formed, namely, as shown in your screen, we have angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3, and angle 4. The question now is, what is now the relationship between the angles 1 and 3. Okay. Okay, very good. You were right. So, the relationship between angle 1 and angle 3 is that it will now form a linear pair. Okay. So, it will now form a linear pair, yung angle 1 and angle 3. So, we can now say that if two angles form a linear pair, we can now say that angle 1 and angle 3 are supplementary. Okay. So, if the two angles now are supplementary, we can now say that the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. Now, what are the pairs of the linear pair? Ano yung mga iba pa pang, ano pa yung mga iba-ibang pair ng linear pair na nabuo dito? So, we have angle 1 and angle 3, angle 3 and angle 2, angle 2 and angle 4, and angle 4 and angle 1. So, those are the pair that are supplementary. Next, what about the relationship between angle 3 and 4? Okay. So what is now the relationship between angle 4, angle 3, angle 1 and angle 2? Okay. So the relationship between these two pairs of angles, they are the what we so called the vertical angles. Okay, you were right. So these are the pairs of vertical angles. So if it is a vertical angles, we can now say that the pair of angles and those vertical angles are congruent to each other. Okay, so di na natin i-emphasize ano po ang vertical angles since you have the idea about the vertical angles. Okay, now let's proceed to our main lesson. So, the question here in the next slide is, how can you be able to determine or identify the exterior angles of a polygon? So, do you have any idea in finding or determining the exterior angles of a polygon? Okay, so don't worry, because as we go along the way, as I mentioned earlier, so matututunan nyo rito kung paano natin madetermine or ma-identify ang exterior angle ng polygon. So, but before we proceed, so since nabigay ko sa inyo yung ano, yung triangle dun sa unang dun sa previous slide, so I have a trivia for you. So according to Science Made Fun 2020, one shape is favorite among the architects are the triangle or is the triangle. So bakit gustong-gusto ng mga architects ang triangle? Because the triangle is the strongest shape capable of holding its shape, having a strong base, and providing immense support. So, we have some of the world's most famous architectural marvels, like the yung nasa Paris, yung the Eiffel Tower. We have the Great Pyramid sa Egypt, and we have the Louvre, or yung ang hirap may pronounce, yung Louvre Pyramid sa Paris din po yan matatagpuan. Okay. So those are just some of the famous architects wherein the triangle is being associated. Okay. Next, so hindi magpapauli ang ating Philippines. So syempre may pinagmamalaki rin tayo sa ating bansa. So dito we have our native Mangyans, the Mangyans of Mindoro. Also, they use the concept of triangle that is being used by our native indigenous group of peoples. As I mentioned earlier, they are the Mangyans of Mindoro. So, one of the familiar structure of the Mangyans are the famous, the what we so called, the Hanunu Mangyan House. So, this Hanunu Mangyan House, it is in the structure wherein it is built by using the figures of triangle. So with these formations, it is been said that the construction of this Hanunu Mangyan House is very steep. The Hanunu Mangyan House, which triangles are associated for the strong foundation of the Hanunu Mangyan House. So with the use of the triangle shapes, the foundation of the Hanunu Mangyan House is it makes it become stronger. So nagamit siya ng ating mga ninuno, yung tinatawag natin na mga Mangyans ng Mindoro. Okay. So much for that. Sa Philippines pa rin po, the use of triangles were being associated by our Philippine architectures or a Philippine architects. So like yung sa Philippine Arena sa Bulacan, yung Buntun Bridge, which the Buntun Bridge is a river bridge that extends from the city of Tuguegarao to Suluna in the Cagayan. And we have the San Juanico Bridge, which is the famous bridge that connects the Samar and Leyte. Okay, let's go back to the given problem. So the problem is, how can you be able to determine or identify the exterior angles of a polygon? Do you have any idea? Okay, good. So to be able to determine or identify the exterior angles of a polygon, it has been said that an exterior angle of a polygon is formed by extending one of the sides of the polygon outside of the polygon. So, literally, in the first statement of the given a paragraph here, that we can create or we can be able to determine the exterior angle of a given polygon by just extending one of the sides of the polygon outside of the polygon. So, thus creating an angle supplementary to the interior angle. So, nabanggit po dito sa second statement na pag nagkaroon daw po tayo ng angle doon sa exterior ng polygon, it is now supplementary to the interior angle at that vertex. Okay, please remember of that. Because of the congruence of vertical angles, it doesn't matter which side is extended. Okay. Because of the vertical angle congruence daw, it doesn't really affect which side is being extended. Because the exterior angle will be the same. So don't worry kahit anong side po yung ma-extend nyo dyan, kasi hindi po magbabago yung exterior angle. It is because of the vertical angle congruence. Okay. For instance, let's say we have now triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, how can we be able to determine the exterior angles of this triangle? So we all know that triangle has three sides. Always remember na dun sa previous lessons na binibigay ko sa inyo, na the number of sides is equal to the number of vertices, it is also equal to the number of interior angles, and also it is equal to the number of exterior angles. So we can be able to determine the exterior angles by just extending the sides. So don't worry kahit anong side ang ma-extend nyo. In either direction, the exterior angle will be the same. Okay, let's say we extend side AC. So kung makikita nyo po yung yellow line, we can now be able to create there an exterior angle. Next, let's say we extend side AB. Okay, next, extend side BC. So we now have three exterior angles here, namely angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3. So those three angles are the exterior angles. And those three exterior angles are supplementary to those interior angles kung nasaan yung vertex ng exterior angle na yon. Okay, malamang po, yung mga nasa loob na angle, they are now called the interior angles. Okay, so sino po ba dito yung mga supplementary angles? We have angle 1 and angle 4, angle 2 and angle 5, angle 3 and angle 6. So, dyan po yung pag-determine natin or pag-locate ng exterior angle. Next, how about we have here a convex quadrilateral? So, by extending the sides, yan. So, na-extend na natin yung mga sides. Then, we will now be able to determine the exterior angles. Let's say we have the angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. Okay. So, na-determine na po natin yung mga exterior angles. Now, the question now is, how can you be able to determine or how can you be able to find the measure of an exterior angle of a convex polygon? Do you have any idea? Okay, so since you don't have any idea in finding the measure of each exterior angle of a polygon, so don't worry because i-discuss natin siya dito. So, next question is, what is the sum of the exterior angle of a convex polygon? So, do you have any idea again? Okay. So what if one of the exterior angle is known or unknown, I'm sorry, what will you do to determine its measure? Okay, so those are just some of the questions being arised as we go along the way. Okay, so yung mga questions na yun po, sasagutan natin hanggang matapos po yung presentation natin. So maybe some of you may say that you can find the measure of an exterior angle of a polygon by just subtracting the interior angle to 180 degrees. Okay, you are right. So, pwede natin daw mahanap ang measure ng exterior angle by just subtracting the measure of the interior angle to its adjacent exterior angle. So, we already know that it is being emphasized that if it is supplementary angles, the sum of its angles is 180. So, pwede nyong makuha ang exterior angle by just subtracting if given ang interior angle to 180 degrees. Maybe some of you will think that to find the measure of the interior angle is by first finding the measure of each interior angle of a polygon by using the formula. So, since we have the formula in finding the measure of each interior angle, which is we have the quantity of n minus 2 times 180 divided by n. Okay, so maybe yun po yung mga pwedeng nasa isip nyo ngayon. Okay, so yun po yung questions. Ito na, na-post ko na. So the first question is how to determine or find the measure of an exterior angle of a convex polygon. What is the sum of the exterior angle of a convex polygon? And if one of the exterior angle is unknown, what will you do to determine its measure? So don't worry because as we go along the process, masasagot natin itong mga katanungan na yan. Okay. So, meron po ako ditong prepare na activity. So, the name of the activity is Remember Me. Okay. So, in this activity, so the direction is find my interior angle. So, I have here three regular polygons, namely we have the triangle STE, the quadrilateral lab, and the hexagon ABCDE and F. Okay, so those three figures are regular polygons. Now, the question is now, how can you be able to find the measure of each interior angle? Okay, you're right. So, by using the formula of finding the measure of each interior angle of a convex or regular polygon, which is the quantity of n minus 2 times 180 degrees divided by n. So, in number 1, we have a regular triangle STE. So, pag sinabi po diba natin na regular polygon, ibig sabihin po niyan, equal po ang lahat ng sides and its opposite interior angles. Okay. To be able to find the measure of each interior angle, so by using the formula, so next is, we already know that n is for the number of sides and triangle has 3 sides. Therefore, first is to identify the given where n is equal to 3. So, by substitution, we have the quantity of 3 minus 2 times 180 degrees divided by 3. And to evaluate, so we subtract first. Then, after we subtract 3 minus 2, it becomes 1. Then, we multiply it by 180 degrees. So, we already know that 180 divided by 3 is 60 degrees. So, we can now say that the measure of each interior angle of a regular triangle, the triangle STE, is 60 degrees. Next, let's say, I'm sorry, how about for the quadrilateral lab? So, lab is a square. So, ang square po is a regular polygon. So, same process kanina. So, given the number of sides is 4, by substitution, we will now have 90 as the measure of each interior angle. So, masyadong mabilis lang po ang presentation dito since it has been discussed in the previous lessons. Next is, we have the regular hexagon. So, since it is a regular hexagon, we have the number of sides which is equals to 6. So, by substitution, so the measure of each interior angle is 120 degrees. So, this is just a recall about finding the measures of each interior angle of a regular polygon or a convex polygon. Okay, next, we have here activity 2.1. So, in this activity, you're going to determine the measure of the exterior angles of each polygon. Now, the question is now, what type of polygon is being described in each figure? Good, you were right. So, the first figure in the left side is a regular triangle. And in our right side ng ating screen, it is a convex quadrilateral. Okay. Now, sa tingin niyo po ba kaya, what mathematical theorem did you apply to find the measure of an exterior angle, angle of a polygon? So, paano niyo kaya po mahanap ang measure ng exterior angle? So, anong theorem ang pwede nating may apply? Okay. So, since doon sa previous activity, di ba, na-solve na natin yung ano, yung paano maghanap ng measure ng interior angle ng regular polygon. So, we already know that the sum of the interior angles of a triangle, lahat ng triangle mapa, iskalin man yan, maparegular, alam natin na ang sum ng measure ng lahat ng interior angle ng triangle is 180. Now, in this figure, the triangle here is a regular triangle. So, if it is a regular triangle, ibig sabihin po, ang measure ng bawat interior angle ay pare-pareho. So, by just dividing 180 to 3, we have 60 degrees as the measure of each interior angles. Now, the problem is, how can we be able to determine the measure of the exterior angles? Anyone? Okay, you're right. By applying the relationship of the two angles. Let's say we have angle 1 and angle A. So, the relationship between angle 1 and angle A is that they will now form a linear pair. So, if they form a linear pair, we can now say that angle 1 and angle A is a supplementary angles. So, the sum of the supplementary angles is 180 degrees. If angle A is 60 degrees, therefore, we can now say that the measure of each exterior angle is 120 degrees. Bakit ang measure ng each exterior angle is 120 degrees? Okay, that is good. Because it is an this is a equilateral triangle. So, we already know that if it is an equilateral triangle, the measure of each interior angles are the same and the measure of each exterior angles are the same. Okay, so yun po yun. Okay, next. So, how can we be able to find the sum of the measures of the exterior angle? Okay, so dito na po papasok yung tinatawag natin na polygon exterior angle theorem. Ano ang sinasabi ng polygon exterior angle theorem? Ang sabi dito, if a polygon is a convex polygon, then the sum of each exterior angles, one at each vertex, is equal to 360 degrees. Okay, always remember that it is true to all polygons, to all convex polygons, I mean, that the measure of all exterior angles of a convex polygon, one at each vertex, is always equal to 360 degrees. So, dapat po hindi sosobra sa 360 and hindi rin po kukulang sa 360 degrees. So, always remember ha, na yung about sa polygon exterior angle theorem. Okay. Now, let's move on. Now, in the second problem, yung kanina dun sa pinost natin, di ba, we have the equilateral triangle and we have the convex quadrilateral. In this situation, the measure of each exterior angles are andyan na, binigay. We have the 100 degrees, the 86 degrees, we have 2x degrees, and we have the x degrees. So, the first thing to do is here is to find the value x. To find the, first is find the value of x to be able us to find the measure of 2x degrees and x degrees. So, how can we be able to solve this? Okay, you were right. So, we're using the polygon exterior angle theorem. So, pag sinabi po diba nating polygon exterior angle theorem, dapat lahat daw ng sum ng any convex polygon, ang sum daw ng mga exterior angle nito ay dapat palaging equal sa 360 degrees. Okay. So, by equating it, so, ang gagawin lang natin is we just add yung x degrees, 2x degrees, 86 degrees, plus 100 degrees is i-equate natin ito sa 360 because we already know that the sum of the four exterior angles of a convex quadrilateral is 360 and it is being said and being emphasized in the polygon exterior angle theorem. So, the first thing to do is to combine those similar terms. So, the similar terms here is the x plus 2x and yung mga constant values natin, we have 86 degrees plus 100 degrees. So, let's evaluate. So, x plus 2x, we have 3x. And 86 plus 100 degrees is 186 degrees equals to 360. Now, so next is transpose 186 degrees to the right side over the equal sign. So, we have now 3x equals to 360 degrees minus 180 degrees. Now, let's subtract. We have 3x equals to 174 degrees. So, divide both sides by 3. So, palagi ko itong sinasabi na kung ano yung katabi ng variable na numerical coefficient, yun din po yung magiging divisor. So, magiging divisor natin both sides. So, since the numerical coefficient is 3, so we divided both sides by 3. So, 3 divided by 3 is 1 or cancel out. Then, we divide 174 degrees by 3. We have now the value of x which is 58 degrees. Now, the problem now here is what is now the value of x and 2x? So, since we already know the value of x is 58 degrees, now, second step now is to solve for the value of x. Okay. Since we already know that x is 58 degrees, so we're going now to solve for 2x. So, we just substitute the value of x ng 58 degrees. That's why yung 2x now, it becomes 116 degrees, I mean, and yung x is 58 degrees. Now, to check, we're going to get the sum of the exterior angles. So, dapat po dito, yung magiging sum ng exterior angles ay dapat mag-equal po sa 360. Okay. So let's add yung, di ba, we have x plus 2x plus 86 degrees plus 100 degrees, then it should be summed to 360 degrees. So by substituting x by 58 degrees and dun sa 2x is 116, we have 58 degrees plus 116 degrees plus 86 degrees plus 100 degrees is equal to 360. Then by summing it up, it is 360 degrees equals to 360 degrees. Therefore, we can now say that our answer is correct. So therefore, the measure of all the exterior angles of this convex quadrilateral as shown in the upper rightmost, we have 100 degrees, 86 degrees, and yung 2x is 116 degrees, and yung x degrees is 58 degrees. Okay, did you get it? Okay, very good. Next, okay yan, pinakita ko lang. So yung exterior is 116 degrees, and yung x is 58 degrees. Next, so activity 2.2. So the same lang po, find my measure, pero syempre may konti na siyang trill. Okay. So dito, we have a regular quadrilateral. So we're looking for the exterior angles, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. And we have here a convex polygon. So this is a triangle. So this is a convex polygon having measures of 106 degrees, x degrees, and the other one is also a x degrees. Next, we have a regular hexagon and the convex polygon or the convex 1, 2, 3, 4, convex hexagon. So, bago tayo mag-proceed dyan, bago natin sagutan, kung makikita nyo po yung background niya, it is a what we so call the honeycomb. So, meron na naman akong trivia sa inyo pagdating sa honeycomb. So, sabi nga doon sa TV Patrol yung, alam mo ba? Okay. So, ang alam mo ba na ang honeycomb is a mass of hexagonal prismatic wax cells built by honeybees. So ito pong mga nakikita nyo dyan sa background niyan, ang shape po talaga niya nasa background nyo is a hexagonal prismatic wax cells. So according to Science Made Fun, at ang source ko dun sa, at saka sa kidskiddle.co, ang sabi dyan, it is a perfect regular hexagon na ginawa po ng mga honeybees as their nest. So ito po yung nest na ito. Dito po nila iniimbak yung mga larvae at dito rin nila ini-store yung mga pollen. So ito yung naging way para mabuo o para magkaroon tayo ng honey. So thanks to the honeybees. So yun lang po yung konting trivia natin pagdating sa honeycomb. So ang tawag po niyan is honeycomb. Okay, so much for that. So let's now proceed to our main activity. So in our activity, the direction is we're going to determine the measure of an exterior angle in a given polygon. So first, we have the two polygons here. We have the regular and the convex polygon. So kung mapansin niyo, pagdating po sa regular polygon, so mas madali po nating mahanap ang measure ng exterior angle. Like dito sa nasa left uppermost, we have the regular quadrilateral. So we're looking for the measures of the exterior angle, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. Since the sum of the interior angles of a square is 360 degrees, so by just dividing it by 4, we can now say that the measure of each interior angle is 90 degrees. So dapat hindi na po kayo ma-confused pag maghanap tayo ng interior angle ng isang regular polygon. Since it is being identified that the measure of each interior angles is 90 degrees and by applying the pair of angles, di ba, may mga pair of angles tayo na yung mga pair of angles na ito doon sa the same vertex na yung dalawang pair of angle na ito daw ay magfo-form ng linear pair. So we can now say na pag ito di ba po ay linear pair, mayigi silang supplementary. Okay. If ang angle 1 and yung angle A na nasa interior ay supplementary. So, di ba, if it is a regular polygon, we can now say that the measure of each exterior angles is also the same to each other. So, by using the supplementary, we just subtract 180 to 90 degrees. That's why we can now say that the measure of each exterior angle is 90 degrees. So, yun po ang magiging measure ng exterior angle. So, like I said earlier, mas madali po nating mahanap ang exterior angle ng theorem kung ang isang polygon ay regular polygon. So, how can we be able to check? So, dapat, pag inadd po natin ang lahat ng exterior angle, it should be summed up to 360 degrees. So, since it has 4 exterior angles, so we're going to add 490 degrees. So, we have 90 degrees plus 90 degrees plus 90 degrees plus 90 degrees. We have 360 degrees. So, therefore, our answer is correct. How about in the next polygon? So, in the next polygon, we have a convex polygon or it is a triangle. Wherein dito, sa nakikita nyo sa upper right most ng screen, we have the exterior angles. Ang mga given po is 106 degrees, x degrees, and also x degrees. So, we already know about the polygon exterior angle theorem that the sum of the measures of exterior angles of any convex polygon is equal to 360 degrees. So, by applying the theorem, so we just combine x degrees plus x degrees plus 100 degrees, then equate it to 360 degrees. So, first thing to do here is to find the value of x since we're looking for the value of x as the exterior angle of this convex polygon. So, combine similar terms, we have 2x plus 106, then transpose yung 106 over the equal sign to 360 degrees. We have 2x equals to 360 degrees minus 106 degrees. Okay. Then, by subtracting, we have 2x equals to 254 degrees. So, divide both sides by 2. The value of x now is 127 degrees. So, the measure of the two x's as the exterior angle of the convex polygon is 127 degrees. So, we have now the measures of the exterior angle, which is 106 degrees, 127 degrees, plus 127 degrees. And if we sum it up, it will sum up to 360 degrees. So, do you follow? Okay, that's good. So, now let's proceed. So, next, let's say we have now a regular hexagon. So, pag regular, as I mentioned earlier, mas madali po talaga nating makuha ang exterior angle unless iba po ang given. So, if it is a regular hexagon, okay, so kung regular hexagon po siya, di ba alam na natin na ang sum ng interior angles ng hexagon ay 720 degrees. Okay, so now, first thing to do para mahanap natin, di ba, ang exterior angle is i-divide muna natin yung 720 degrees to the number of sides of this piece polygon. Excuse me. Since this polygon is a regular hexagon, so we divide yung 720 degrees by 6. That's why we can now say that the measure of each interior angle is 120 degrees. If the measure of each interior angle is 120 degrees, so by just applying the supplementary angles or the linear pair, so we just subtract 180 by 120 degrees, we will have the measure of each exterior angle, which is equal to 60 degrees. So, by summing it up, the six exterior angles, we have 360 degrees, and that is correct. Okay, next, how about the problem if it is a convex polygon? So, kung mapansin niyo po yung mga examples natin, mag-generalize natin na mas madali po talagang mahanap ang mga exterior angles kung ang polygon po ay regular. So, nagkakaroon lang po ng thrill in finding the exterior angle sa mga convex polygon. So, like in this next example. So, our solution here is, first is to gawin nating equation siya. Okay, so since we have 6 exterior angles dito, we have the 90 degrees plus x minus 25 degrees plus 25 degrees plus x degrees, plus x minus 5 degrees, and x minus 45 degrees. So, para maging convenient po kayo sa pagsusolve ng gantong karaming equation na may mga variables, unang-una po is ilagay nyo muna sa mga parentheses yung mga given na exterior angle. So, as shown here in the screen. Next is, saka na natin sila ilabas sa parentheses. Next is to combine those similar terms. So, we have 4x's here. So, i-combine natin itong mga similar terms. We have x plus x plus x plus x. Then, the constant values, we have 90 minus 25 plus 25 minus 5 minus 45 equals to 360 degrees. Then by combining similar terms, we have 4x plus 40 degrees equals to 360 degrees. Then by transpose natin yung 40 degrees, we will now have 4x equals to 360 degrees minus 40 degrees. Okay. So now, we have 4x equals to 320 degrees. So the numerical coefficient of the variable x is 4. So divide both sides by 4. Therefore, the value of x is 80 degrees. Now, the question is, are we done? Good, not yet. Because ang nahanap pa lang po natin is the value of x. So paano natin mahanap yung measure ng exterior angle of a polygon? Okay, you were right. So, by substitution. So, isa-substitute na natin yung value ng x, which is 80, doon sa mga variable na x. So, let's say sa x minus 25, substitute it by 80, 80 degrees minus 25 degrees, we have 55 degrees doon sa exterior angle na may x minus 25. Kung makikita nyo dyan sa rightmost ng inyong screen, yung x minus 25 is 55 degrees. Next, we solve for x minus 5 degrees, it becomes 75 degrees. And for x minus 45 degrees, is we have 80 minus 45, we have 35 degrees. So, ang sabi dun sa polygon exterior angle theorem, that the sum of any polygon of convex polygon is always 360 degrees. So, by summing it up, so to check, we have 90 degrees plus 55 degrees plus 25 degrees, plus 80 degrees, plus 75 degrees, plus 35 degrees. So, dapat magisyang 360. So, by summing it up, we have 360 degrees is equal to 360 degrees. So, we can now say that our answer is correct. So, do you follow class? Okay. So, very good. So, thumbs up for that. Next is, okay. So, now let's have a group activity. So, diba, na-divide ko na po kayo sa tatlong grupo. So, bibigyan ko lang po kayo ng tig pa 5 minutes para gawin po itong activity. So, ipa-flash ko lang po bawat problem sa bawat group. So, for group 1, so, 3 exterior angles of a pentagon measure 60 degrees, 80 degrees, and 90 degrees. Find the measure of the other 2 exterior angles assuming that they are equal. Okay. Next is, for group 2, find the measure of angle 1. Okay, so pakihanap po yung angle 1. If yung ibang exterior, we have 75 degrees, 105 degrees, and 92 degrees as shown in your screens. Okay, please copy. Next, last for group 3 is, the problem is here, the measure of the exterior angles of a convex quadrilateral whose vertices are 3x, 4x minus 10, 2x plus 10, and x plus 3. Find the measure of each exterior angle. So, as you can see, sa different sa iba-ibang grupo, may level po kung mapansin nyo yung problem. So, actually po, na-discuss natin lahat kung ano yung ang dito sa pinapagawa ko sa inyong group activity. So, lahat po yan ay na-discuss natin. So, alam kong kayang-kaya yung sagutan yan. So, in 10 minutes, timer starts now. Time's up. Okay. So, now let's have a group presentation. So, okay, let's check your work for group 1. So, for group 1, so, ang magiging sagot natin dito, since ang problem po, diba, dun is assuming that they are equal. So, the answer for group 1 and group 2 is shown here in the screen. So, you were right. So, nakuha niyo po yung tamang sagot. So, ang sagot po sa number 1 is 65 degrees. So, the measure of the other 2 exterior angles is 65 degrees. So, yan po yung sagot sa group 1. So, tama kayo group 1. So, let's have a clap. Okay. Sa group 2 naman, so this is now the answer. Okay. Tama ang group 2. We have 88 degrees as the measure of angle 1. So, now let's check for the group 3. Okay. Very good. So, napakaganda ng presentation ng group 3. So, ang ginawa nila, tulad ng ginawa natin dun sa discussions natin, we just first add muna natin yung mga exterior angles, yung mga given. So, as shown in the screen. So, that is good presentation, group 3. Okay, thank you for for your participations. Okay, thank you. Now, ito na yung, di ba, yung pinakita ko sa inyo doon sa umpisa ng lesson natin. Nag-post ako ng isang problem. So, this is a practical application. So, now, since bali po na-discuss na natin lahat-lahat tungkol sa paghanap ng exterior ng polygon, and by using the polygon exterior angle theorem, now it is now the time to apply what you've learned in the given problem. So the problem here, so basahin natin ulit. So an after school club was doing a crop as preparation for their culminating activity in MAPE. Students are very excited doing their display with paper cut out in the shape of convex regular polygon. If one of the exterior angles has measures of 45 degrees, what is the name of the polygon? So, paano natin ito sasagutan? Okay, so pwede nyong try sagutan sa inyong mga notebooks. So, okay, bigyan ko lang kayo ng 3 minutes para sagutan ang problem na to. Okay, time's up. Everybody, please raise your answers. Okay, so check natin kung tama yung mga sagot nyo. So, sabay-sabay natin siyang sagutan dito sa ating presentation. So, okay. So, di ba? One of the exterior, ang given dun, di ba, is one of the exterior angles has measure of 45 degrees. So, nabanggit dun sa given na ang isa daw dun na exterior angle daw ay may measure ng 45 degrees. Now, let's use dun sa unang recall natin na kung meron ng dalawang angle na nag-intersect, dalawang line na nag-intersect. So, let's say, we have 45 degrees here, dun sa taas, sa angle, and dun sa baba, we have 135 degrees. So, let's now assume that the 45 degrees will be the exterior angle as the given. And let's say yung 135 degrees is the interior angle. So, di ba, we have the formula in finding the measure of each interior angle of a regular polygon, which is ang formula natin is the quantity of n minus 2 times 180 degrees divided by n. So, ang gagawin lang natin dito is gagamitin natin yung formula. Since n is for the number of sides, and this formula is the formula in finding the measure of each interior angle. So, gawin na lang natin, we have the quantity of n minus 2 times 180 degrees divided by n equals 135 degrees. Bakit nilagyan natin ng equal na 135 degrees? Kasi diba, yung kumikita niyo yung angle ng 45 at ang angle ng 135, they are supplementary angles. So, in-apply lang natin kanina yung doon sa opening pa lang ng ating lesson. So, the sum of 45 is 180 degrees. So, by solving the equation and using the formula of n minus 2 times 180 degrees divided by n. So, replace lang natin yung... So, ang gagawin na natin is... evaluate na natin. So, distribute natin yung 180 degrees doon sa n minus 2. We have 180 degrees n minus 360 degrees equals 135 degrees n. So, isolate natin yung may mga variable na n or combine like terms. So, we have 180 degrees n minus 135 degrees n equals 360 degrees. Then, subtract. We have 45 degrees n equals 360 degrees n and divide both sides by 45. Cancel out natin yung 45. So, may gina siyang n or 1n or n. So, 360 degrees divided by 45. Okay. So, we can now say that n is equals to 8, where n is for the number of sides. And if it has 8 sides, therefore, we can now say that it is a regular octagon. So, ang sagot po natin dyan sa practical application is, the name of the polygon is octagon. So, do you get it? Okay, so you were right. So, that's good. So, next is... Okay, so first, let's have a generalizations before ibigay ko sa inyo yung ating evaluation. So, how do you determine the measure of the exterior angles of a polygon? Okay, good. So, tama po kayo. So, it is by applying the formula in finding the sum of the measures of the interior angles of the polygon and by applying the polygon exterior angle theorem, also about the linear pair, the supplementary, and the vertical angle. So, yun lang po. Okay. Next is, let's have an evaluation. So, nag-prepare ako dito ng tatlong questions for our evaluation. So we have figure 1, angle 2, and sa number 3, ito yung problem. So yan po yung magiging evaluation natin. So good for 15 minutes. Okay, so now let's start. Okay, thank you. So now for your assignment. So madali lang tong assignment nyo. So ang assignment natin is you're going to cite some instances or situations where polygon exterior angle theorem is applied in your community. So the submission of your assignment will be on next meeting. Okay, so much for that. Thank you. So before I end this presentation, I would like to share to you the saying of Paul Holmos. So the only way to learn mathematics is to do mathematics. So that's all for today. Thank you and good day.